Critic. And after that last episode about Nicki Minaj, I wanted to do something a little more female positive. Yeah, say what you like about this video showing a woman as having agency in her sexuality, but for me, it was way too pandering to the tastes of thirsty men to be taken seriously. I wanted to find a popular song that more directly catered to what women want.
My neck, my back, lick my pussy and my crack.
Allow me to make an addendum to my statement. I wanted to review a song that could actually be good that got popular and directly catered to what women want. And to my surprise, to find a rap song from a woman's perspective that was good while still breaking through to the mainstream, I only had to go back by about one or two decades. Yeah, going back through hip-hop, the early 90s was actually the most visible time for female rappers. Cats like MC Light, Yo-Yo, and Queen Latifah were out there really putting it down for the ladies. But I feel like the most successful and female-positive rappers of the time were Salt and Pepa. And while they had success first in the 80s with Push It, and people seem to really remember that song the most out of their catalog, I myself was never really into it lyrically. I mean, what are they honestly saying here that really flipped people's wigs?
Can't you hear the music pumping hard like I wish you would?
What, this line? All she's saying is that she wants to hear the music play. Or wait, maybe in addition to telling a guy to listen to the pumping of the music, she's demanding that he should be pumping as hard as the... Oh. Wow, how did I just get that? Well, either way, I don't think they really started coming into their own until the 90s, when they refined their personalities as female rappers who were clearly sexually active, yet they were obviously smart about it. But with them, I always got the feeling that they were writing lyrics that intelligent girls wanted to hear. I mean, they had a song called...
Let's talk about sex, baby. Let's talk about you and me.
But whereas one could easily take the route of hyper-sexualized lyrics, they chose to go another way.
Let's talk about all the good things and the bad things.
They were encouraging people to talk about the whole spectrum of sexuality, telling people that we should be open about talking about what makes us feel good, but also talk about the risks that come with sex, telling us to communicate with each other about our problems and insecurities. Perfect timing too, as Salt and Pepa put this music out right before the era where gangster rap ruled supreme, and if you wanted to be on top as a female rapper, you had to unabashedly exploit your sexuality, but you guys know where that whole story goes. However, I wanted to focus on their highest charting song, because in contrast to Nicki's tales about guys, I wanted to review a song where these ladies talked about guys. So let's look at What a Man by Salt and Pepa. Now I know what you're thinking.
In fact, I always know what you're thinking.
Yeah. But in this particular instance, you may be saying, hey, they're blatantly sampling another song, aren't they? And they are. In vogue to update the old school 60s tune by Linda Lindell for the chorus, and wrote raps that elaborated on the subject, effectively creating an early version of the rap song cover, foreshadowing a whole generation of rappers to not only sample but create direct rap remakes of older songs. And that may annoy you, because instead of building their own song from the ground up, they're just reconstructing an already created song. But for those that absolutely loathe any and all sampling because they feel it's bad for music, here's a little background history. Linda Lindell recorded What a Man back in 1968, and when it started receiving some attention on the radio, she quickly started getting death threats and hate mail from racist groups who didn't like the fact that a white woman was singing black music. And so, after only recording four songs, she retired from music for 2.5 decades purely out of fear. That is, until a little remix of one of her songs got so popular, the royalty checks from said remix reinvigorated her courage to perform music again. The lesson here is, sometimes sampling can be a good thing. But let's get back to the song.
I wanna take a minute or two and give much respect to the man that's made a difference in my world.
Okay, so we kick off automatically with the main point. Salt and Pepa giving praise to a guy that's been good to them.
And although most men are hoes.
Hey, you can't call us that. That's our word to describe you when you want to be as sexually active as we want to be.
I never heard about him with another girl, but I don't sweat it because it's just pathetic to let it get me involved in that he said, she said crowd. I know that ain't nobody perfect. I give props to those who deserve it, and believe me, y'all, he's worth it.
Now, these lines are quite dynamic in what they're representing. They paint the narrator as someone who not only has found someone loyal among the other jerks in the world, but someone to whom she's gained so much trust in that even if there were questions raised by others about his faithfulness, she wouldn't pay it any mind. Because even so, she recognized the imperfections in his humanity, and that despite a fall from grace, she would be willing to stick it out with him, because the bond they share is worth more than any problems they could face. Now, you can see this as her showing herself as weak and willing to accept someone who's infidelitous. if that's the word. But I don't think that's the case. Throughout the song, we get a clear message that Salt and Pepper are not the type of girls who mess with guys who don't actually have true value in their lives.
A lot of snot knows that things couldn't be him. He never ran a corner line once to me yet. He's not a fake wannabe, trying to be a pimp.
See other guys that I've had, they try to play all like Matt had. But every time they tried, I said, that's not it.
It's made apparent that this guy is different, that he indeed fits her standards as a lover. However, I think the acknowledgement of his imperfections is a smart inclusion, because it shows her not as some stuck-up person who has impossibly high expectations of a boyfriend, but someone who's realistic, while still commanding a deeper bond of love and trust. And that makes their triumph as a unit all the more rewarding. Now, some of you might be saying, hey, Rap Critic, this seems less like an analysis of a female positive song, and more like you humble bragging about understanding the core of relationships as some sort of cheap ploy to appeal to your female audience. To which I'd say, yes, yes it is. And if there's one thing I've learned from modern media, it's that blatantly admitting that you're doing something that's obviously pandering makes it completely okay to keep doing it. So ladies, now that I'm back on the market after falling out with a certain young lady, I'd like to use this song to affirm from a female point of view, that point of view being the lyrics written by a woman here, that I indeed embody the male specimen for which you seek.
I finally found somebody that could make me laugh.
Hey, I know women like a sense of humor. That's why I have a comedy show.
You so crazy. I think I wanna have your baby.
Women really like a sense of humor.
My man is smooth like Barry and his voice got bass.
Is that a fact? Well, I do believe I'm currently fitting the bill for this ideal gentleman of which you speak.
A body like Arnold with a Denzel face.
Well, ladies, I'm sure you're aware of my devilish good looks. And I'm still working on this part, but, you know, I'll get back to you.
And yes, it's me that he's always choosing. With him, I'm never losing, and he knows that my name is not Susan.
That's oddly specific. But seriously, I believe this line is actually referring to a Whitney Houston song of the same name, in which Whitney gets angry at her boyfriend for accidentally calling her by the name of a past lover.
My name is not Susan.
And of course, they're saying that they don't have to worry about that in their relationship. But back to me bragging about being a potential boyfriend. Ladies, I may not have Arnold Schwarzenegger's abs, but I guarantee you one thing. I will never call you Susan.
What if my name's actually Susan?
Nope, not even then. You see, unlike some men, I stick to my commitments.
My man gives real love and that's why I call him killer.
Well, killer seems a bit extreme, but I think I see your point.
He takes his time and does everything right.
Well, if you're a fan of my show, you know I do all of this myself. And I always take the time to do it right. Yeah.
Knocks me out with one shot for the rest of the night.
Oh yes, ladies. I'll always be sure to... Wait, say that again?
Knocks me out with one shot for the rest of the night.
Unfortunately, I don't think I'm gonna be able to fulfill that role. Sorry, it's just not me. Unless, of course, you're talking about sex. In which case, you want me to, like, sex-wise, knock you out with one shot? Jeez, I can't do that either. I'm gonna need at least, like, 50. I mean, maybe that's partially due to the un-Schwarzeneggerness of the abs, but come on, give me some leeway.
Spends quality time with his kids when he can.
Okay, that's a little easier. I can work with that.
Secure in his manhood, cause he's a real man.
And I can do that too. In fact, I'm so secure in my manhood for the last couple of episodes, I've been recording without pants. Or boxers.
Every time I need him, he always got my back. Never disrespectful, cause his mama taught him that.
As well, my mom's instilled in me the proper way to treat the ladies. So if you end up with me, it will be to you that I will always remain respectful and pantsless. Overall, I give this a 5 out of 5. The song has an old school yet somehow timeless vibe to it, unlike a lot of other very dated rap music of the time. I mean, maybe adding some unnecessary synths and autotune, but you know. And the rhymes are on point, showcasing chilled out, flavorful lyrics about what these two women look for in a relationship. And they stay focused and deliver a sadly seldom heard subject in a way that's fun to listen to and doesn't easily get old. Go ahead and check this one out, and some of Salt and Pepper's other joints as well. I think you'll dig it. Well, I'm the Rap Critic. And I still haven't come up with a catchphrase for signing off after a positive review.